Welcome to a very exciting little yellow package. This was sent to me by one of my viewers who goes under the YouTube channel Hans Wurst, but I prefer to refer to him by his first name, which is Martin. So Martin, thank you very much for sending this my way. Inside this package is a challenge log that he made and where he put a lot of effort into it. Finally, after his last modifications, he wrote me, he was not able to pick it anymore. And he wants to see me picking it on camera and wants to hear my opinion on it. Well, so I'm very curious to see what's inside. Let's open it up. And he told me to use a shim to open it. So hopefully I will remember it. So here is the lock. Oops, and a little plastic container, very nice. So it's a Yale, key is Mamet. So I can get no information about the bidding, which makes picking a bit harder, of course. Yale. So let's see, how does the keyway look like? Not really bad. Okay, let's clamp it in a vise and give it a try. So I refer to this as attempt number one. Okay. Focus. Yes, focus. So I will protect the keyway like so. No, that's too thick. Need a smaller one. Okay. Then I start with a, let's see if I can get, yeah, that could work. I start with a slightly modified Peterson gem in 15,000ths. I can somehow reach up. Let's see. Maybe I have to change picks later on. And for tensioning, oh, it's floppy. It's a 1.0 millimeter Peterson pry bar. I think I can get the thick one in it. It's the 1.3 millimeters. Oh, I can hardly see it. All right. Or not all right. No, it's too thick. Oh, I think it fits, but it's a tight fit. Yeah, tight fit is good, because then I can control the plug back and forth manually. So I go counterclockwise. All right. So I'm really curious what will happen now. Okay, so one is loose, two is loose. I think three is binding. Got some clicks. Four. Okay, five. Okay, so this is attempt number two. First attempt I stopped after 9 minutes in total. So now I try again, picking it again counterclockwise. This time I used this other slightly modified Peterson gem in 18,000ths. And start from the back. No feedback. Okay. It was six, I believe. All right, so this is attempt number three. The second attempt brought me a nice deep fall set, but then I messed it up. So meanwhile, I added some screws here in the back to give it a better fit in my vise. Yeah. Counterclockwise, and this hook here from Sparrows, a deeper one. And let's start. Very light tension. Yeah, that feels good. And one is always very easy to overset. Some clicks from two, very nice. Now three is given feedback. And I bet he has countermilled the chambers in the plug. Because this boulder wanted to pick his second attempt, just didn't wanna be set, and then I reset everything. Alright, some clicks from the back. And one was overset. A running gag in this lock, the overset pin. But it easily returns. Okay, got a nice deep four set now again. Some clicks here from 5 or 6, not sure if it's a 6 or 5 pinner. Once I get into this four set, it's a very talkative lock. So that is 2. Ah, nice, that was a spool and I got it. Okay, that was a spool in the back, but I lost the full set and one was overset, so now it's back. Just has to release a little bit of the tension and then one returns all the time. Oops, that was more than one, but it's okay. And the full set increased. And again, feedback from 2, or maybe it fell down. And nice full set. That was about the situation. Ha ha! It's not about like the situation in the second attempt, because now it's open. So, that's it. The luck is open. Yeah, on the third attempt. First was about 9 minutes in total with the introduction. Third was about, let's say, I don't know. I have to look it up in the video, but maybe 5 minutes when I messed it up at the very deep four set, and now it's open. Wow. I'm really curious to see the pins, so I shall use a shim, he told me. And I will do this, of course. But first we'll have a look at the bidding. Let's see. Oops. So that's a nice bidding. Wow. So very, very deep cut at 1. That was the overset trap. Then 2 a little bit shorter. 3 very short. Then a deeper one, a longer one, and again a very short one in the back. So that's a really good bidding for a challenge lock. Wow. Great. All right. So let's have a look inside. I lock it back up, or maybe not. Yeah, I tried to remove the clip without locking it. Maybe I can use my pinning shoe instead of a shim, because I'm not the greatest shimmer in the world. Not the greatest clip remover. Okay, got it. I think I have to destroy this nasty clip to get it off. I hope I didn't damage the pins, because it's 180. Okay, so now let me think. I need my pinning shoe. Does it fit? I hope so. But it's not great. I know he told me to use a shim, but this feels very good. So, yeah, let's hope for the best. All right, this worked out pretty well. So let's remove the shoe. Okay, so here we go. We have a 5-pin lock with all the pins in and working nicely. There is something strange with 3. It's wobbling around, but we will see. So there is 1. It's a very long key pin standard. And we have 2. It's one with 2 serrations. 3 is a T-pin. 4 is a serrated, and 5 is a standard. Okay, let's have a look at the plug. What do we have here? Come on, focus. We have no modifications. Let me see. We have no modifications, no counter milling. They are a little bit enlarged, but I think that's factory made. So if this is a very precisely made lock with tight tolerances, then it's probably a good idea not to threaten the chambers, because then you are facing or you're risking to reduce the precision in this lock, so that's good. Let me orient these pins a little bit nicer, so it goes like this, like that, and like so. Okay, so now let's have a look at the drivers. So, oh, one is really, really, yeah, it's barely breaking out here. So that's a very weak spring, which makes it easy to overset, and that's what I experienced. Easily overset one, and let me see, goes like this. It's a hollow pin. You can see it's a hollow pin, serrated hollow pin. Wow, great work, really, really nice. But what, and the spring, so no inside pin. That's interesting. Let's continue with 2. That's a very long spool. Oh, okay, and I messed it up with 3. 3 is a serrated. We have a spool in 4. Spring doesn't want to go out. And what's the last? Wow, oops, that's a pin in pin. All right. So let's see if there are modifications here in the chambers of the Bible. I don't think so. But it's interesting. We have a cut through the chambers here. I've never seen that before. I don't know why this is the case, but it seems to be a factory made. Maybe I remove the cap to have a closer look. Hope that I can get it back on. I think so. Shouldn't be too difficult. Or maybe not. Okay, let's see. I think I will get it back on. Yeah, here we go. We can see this cut here, but no modifications here. All right. So let's have a look at these pins really close. the camera would focus. All right, so we have a standard very long keeping in one, an overset trap with a double serrated with, it's a hollow pin. Not sure why this is hollow. Number two, keeping is double serrated and we have a very long spool. Then we have a T-pin in number three as keeping. Two serrations on the driver. Then we have a spool as a driver in four with a serrated keypin in, with a serrated keypin. Then we have a standard keypin in five and a really, really nicely made pin in pin with serrations. Wow. Really, really nice. Okay, so I have to say that this was really a tricky pick. Great work on the pins. So if you look at these serrated hollow pins, that's very, very nice. And to make a little pin like this hollow and serrated, this requires a lot of skills. Okay, let's check the effectiveness. So we got one in here. Although there is not much space left here for the driver, one serration is still there. I'm not really sure if it was actually too effective because it was really easily set and easily overset as well, but also easily recovered. But I think it's a very nice pin. So let's see number two. It's definitely effective with it. Yeah, that's perfect. It's very, very effective. Great. So then we have a key pin, T-pin, with a double serrated, which is also very nicely designed, just as it should be. We have a serrated key pin and a spool. Also very effective, great. And we have a very short one and very, very effective. So this is really very nicely designed, great work on the pin, and it was a real challenge to pick and a great fun as well. I feel really, really honored that this lock was sent to me. So Martin, thank you very, very much for sending this my way. And I will send you some challenge locks as you asked me. So everybody who would like to see Martin picking these locks that I will send to him, please go and subscribe to him. I will put a link in the description of this video. And so he will be encouraged to make some videos. All right. So thank you very much for watching. Happy picking and bye-bye.